While most clubs are busy discussing their transfer targets for the summer, Nottingham Forest are closing in on their second signing of the window in New Zealand international midfielder Marko Stamenic. This lad has had quite the journey to the top. In 2019, he caught the eye at the Under-17 World Cup in a game against Brazil, and was actually close to signing for Flamengo based on that single performance. However, Danish giants Copenhagen hijacked the deal, and shortly after, Stamenic became the first footballer from New Zealand to feature in the Champions League since 2007. Had the COVID lockdown not happened, Stamenic would be even further along the line in his development, but nonetheless, he won the Danish Cup before departing to Red Star in February of last year. Now, on paper, that might appear to be a bit of a random move, but given his father's Serbian heritage, it made complete sense to sign for the biggest club in the country. He's just come off the back of a campaign where he won the league and cup double with them, and feels ready to take the next step forward in his career. Stylistically, Stamenic plays all across midfield, whether that's sitting in front of the back four in the Makalele role, or pushing further upfield as a number 10. Although he's not particularly renowned for his end product, the lad does have excellent technical ability, which is showcased by his passing between the lines. As you'd expect in a modern day footballer operating centrally, he's incredibly press resistant, which is a great attribute to have when backs are against the wall. Truth be told, his physicality and aerial ability need a bit of work, but I'm confident that will come with age. Should everything go to plan, he's expected to join Forest's sister club Olympiacos on a season-long loan. One can only hope he impresses sufficiently enough to get a Premier League gig with Forest in 2025. After all, Coventry were a whisker away from getting Stamenic through the door earlier this week, and I'm sure he harbors long-term aspirations of plying his trade in English football. Please do consider subscribing for more Forest and football-related content. I need your help to get to 10,000 subscribers. And I'll catch you in the next one, folks. Peace.